Armenia, Azerbaijan, and Russia have signed an agreement to end 6 weeks of fierce fighting in Nagorno-Karabakh. More in this report.
The Nagorno-Karabakh conflict, which simmered for decades despite international efforts to mediate, erupted into fresh fighting in late September. Three ceasefires have failed in the past 6 weeks. As of today, Azerbaijan, Armenia, and Russia have reached a new deal to end the conflict that has left over 1,200 people dead. In a televised meeting, Russian President Vladimir Putin confirmed the total ceasefire.
Today on November 9, President of Republic of Azerbaijan Ilham Aliyev, Prime Minister of Republic of Armenia Nikol Pashinyan, and President of Russian Federation signed a statement which declares the complete ceasefire and any military action in Nagorno-Karabakh war zone starting from midnight of November 10, 2020 Moscow time. The Azerbaijan Republic and the Republic of Armenia stop at the present positions.
Azeri President Ilham Aliyev said the historic agreement showed that it was a clear defeat of Armenia. Aliyev said the Armenians signed the agreement due to Baku's iron fist, not Yerevan's own will. He also announced a Turkish and Russian joint peacekeeping mission in Karabakh. Under the deal, Azerbaijan says it keeps the territorial gains and Armenia has agreed to give three regions around the Nagorno-Karabakh to Baku. In Baku, the capital of Azerbaijan, news of the agreement brought people to the streets to celebrate despite a curfew. But in Armenia, the agreement sparked outrage with protesters storming Prime Minister Nikol Pashinyan's official residence in Yerevan. They called for the resignation of Pashinyan after he announced the painful deal. Commenting on the unrest, Pashinyan said anyone involved would be severely punished. Hours before the agreement was signed, Azerbaijan apologized to Moscow after it admitted shooting down a Russian helicopter by mistake. Two crew members died in the incident and a third was injured.